My literary story begins in the small town of Liberty, South Carolina. That's about 45 minutes away from Wythampton. Now, I can't really remember how old I was when I first started reading, and neither can my mom. I do, however, remember begging my stepdad to read to me from my favorite books, like The Little Red Hen. But above all, there was one book in particular I would beg for him to read to me over and over. That book was Goldilocks Has Chicken Pox. Once he refused to read to me anymore, I would read it by myself every night. Moving on to second grade, I wrote my very first book. It was titled The Three Goats That Would Share. Sadly, when I moved from Liberty, I lost the book, so I can't show you a picture of it, which really stinks because all the illustrations were my own. I began trying to read books like The Hobbit at this time also. In fact, for my birthday that year, my great aunt gave me the book Pride and Prejudice. It wasn't until a few years later that I understood my love for books. Growing up, I never quite fit in, so when I read books, I could go to a completely different world where I was the main character and lived a different life. I would get lost in those worlds, whether the books were based on true stories or just fantasies. My mom had me read the Mandy books a lot because my great-great-aunt Lois Leppard wrote them. I'm writing my blood, and I think that is one reason I'm so passionate about it. My stepdad was a musician, and he started to teach me guitar when I was only 7. From there, I went on to playing piano, to violin, to mandolin, organ, and ukulele. When it came to sheet music, I found it a lot harder to read than just a normal book. I only ever learned how to read sheet music for violin, piano, and mandolin, but I'm still trying to learn to read music for all the other instruments. Over the years, I've become more literate, changing my taste in books as well. I first read the Twilight books when I was in 6th grade, and I loved them. After rereading them in 9th grade, I hated them. I went from reading Twilight by Stephanie Meyer to reading The Fault in Our Stars by John Green, which I highly recommend. 7th grade, we started to study poetry. I quickly fell in love with it. That year, I discovered that my favorite poem was Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe, and to this day, that has not changed. Not only did I love to read poetry, but I loved to write it. It was from there that my writing skills began to develop and form. Some may say that that's a late start, but I digress. From poetry to songs to short stories. In fact, my freshman year of high school, I had an online blog where I wrote a story, and each post was a different chapter. Once I finished the story, I decided I would delete the blog. Maybe someday I'll write something I find good enough to save. Once I started high school, I fell in love with theater. I had always enjoyed watching plays, but I enjoyed being in them even more. I'd always loved reading in between the lines, and now I got to do that more often. It's one thing to read dialogue in a book, but to deliver the dialogue yourself is an absolutely amazing feeling. Today, some of my favorite books are 20 Boy Summer, Don't Breathe a Word, The Perks of Being a Wallflower, Pink, The Fault in Our Stars, An Abundance of Catherines, To Kill a Mockingbird, and many more. I think that over time, my reading skills have increased, and so have the caliber of the books I read. Although my story isn't necessarily life-changing or exciting, it's still my literary story, and I'm proud of it. I'm proud of where my reading and writing has taken me, and I can't wait to see where I go next.